2014 and do a few tweaks. But I'm going to point out, in the essence of time here, the things that our first platform does not say anything about modernizing our 1936 Social Security card. That's the most counterfeited card in the world. And that's what all these folks go get in the flea market if they work for legitimate employers who deed up to match taxes. That complies with our I-9 law because it looks to be legitimate. That's what the law says. If he otherwise qualifies, his identification looks to be legitimate, and you don't hire him because you suspect he's illegal, then you have violated the law. You have discriminated, and the EEOC comes after you. And there are many things. Number two, we have not done this. And this is not in the plan. We need to demand a positive ID of every non-citizen in this country and a criminal background check. Lord, folks, we don't even know who's in our house, okay? Because Congress has not got the guts to address the issue, okay? And number three, and some of you won't like this, but I'm telling you, unless you want to train to Dachau and deport 20 million people, we need a guest worker program that includes a positive ID, medical screening, criminal background check, and citizen first incentives. And probably the most important thing, and this is obviously not in the plan either currently, we need to require that whoever we give a guest worker card to, that they work only for employers that deduct and match taxes. Right now, no, only God knows for sure, but I believe that 60-70% of the undocumented workers or aliens or whatever you want to call them are being paid off the books and called independent contractors so we don't have to deduct and match Social Security and Medicare, don't have to pay them overtime, don't have to insure my workers' comp or pay taxes on employment. These 4 points actually address the meat of the problem. You give these people a legal ID, one of the things some of us may not like is it's going to wind up raising the average wages of the laborers in the field who are working because they then can negotiate with their boss without fear of deportation. And it's going to raise the wages for everybody. And it's going to help the union, and I'm not a union supporter. But right now, we're not getting any of the payroll taxes. And that is cheating the system. Where they are working for an employer, we're collected. But I'm telling you that is a small and smaller percent. I'm out of time. God bless y'all for being here.
All right.
Mr.
Linger,
that was my daddy.
What do we do with the people who have broken the law, who are here? I mean, do we overlook the law?
Well, okay, so let me just say that.
Is it a mass forgiveness?
No. Well, first of all, that's when you get down into the technicalities of it, it would be my personal opinion, if I'm sitting in Congress, that if you came up here of your own free will and you were an adult, and you're on a visa and you overstayed your visa, you'd still be subject to a fine. If you came here without a visa, you'd be subject to a bigger fine. If you were brought here as a kid, I wouldn't fine you, okay? But I don't care. There has to be a system. And it cannot be you just get a guest card. That's what Ronald Reagan gave him offered it to 3 million in 1986. It was pure amnesty. Nobody's promoting that. And as far as the concern, Rush Limbaugh's always talking about, well, if you let them in, they're all going to be Democratic voters. There should be no shortcuts to citizenship. And if you go the regular route, back of the line of provisions, that's a 15-year process. And so anyway, guys, I just write down what we're lacking. In the 2014 plank, I mean, it actually includes the words, any method of legalization is amnesty. Well, I'm sorry, if you decide that and accept that, then we've offered no solution. We've just kicked the can down the road, and it's you're offering no solution. I mean, we've got a heck of a problem. We all agree on that.
One other thing, I can see this coming a mile down the road. You start with a program where people have some form of status through which they're paying taxes. The very next shoe to fall is, why these poor people are paying taxes and they have no representation, well, they just deserve to vote. I mean,
that's
a shortcut to citizenship, and that could not happen. That's unacceptable. That's unacceptable.
What I would be worried about, sir, is the law of unintended consequences.
Yep.
So I understand that we have a large issue. It's a sticky issue. It defies very simplistic solutions, but
there's not a simple solution. Honestly. But I understand what you're saying, and I'm just telling you currently, I mean, we can cause us. There's a multitude of problems with the illegal aliens here, okay? There's a multitude of problems. But we have no solution on the table. We need to take a solution that can work. It's got to be tough. It's got to put citizens first. It's got to be tough. But we need to start collecting payroll taxes on the people that are building the houses. And listen, today, I insure commercial contractors. And I'm telling you, a legitimate contractor who has completed design and has paying tax and workers' compensation, he's got competitors who have no labor burden because they're hiring these illegals.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, I have one more question. All right. I'm so sorry. Okay. So yesterday, when you spoke, you talked about employers being kind of caught in a grinder between agencies. And so I'm going to ask you to quickly clarify that for me again.
Okay.
What is the fix for that? Is that fixing the Social Security card?
Well, that's the first step.
First step? Okay.
First step, because right now it can be so easily counterfeit.
Right
now, if an employer complies with the labor law, he completes an I-9, which says if they present ID that looks to be legitimate and they otherwise qualify, you have to hire or you're discriminating. And the EEOC enforces the discrimination law big time. Okay? So Security sends out the no match letter on employers that have more than 100 people.
So that is E-verified, right? Is it
no, 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 no. That's not E-verified. Okay. That's a completely different program.
Okay.
The no match letter has been coming out for 15 years, not the Social Security office, and it goes at random. And it says this number and this name don't match in our files. Okay, but we're collecting money. They've never refunded any of it to the employer, but that's fine. I hope they keep it all. So at any rate, but it tells the employer on the no match letter, you cannot fire this person. You have to tell them to contact us and get the problem straightened out. That's what it does. Okay, now Homeland Security has since come out with a rule that says, hey, if you get no match letters, we're going to consider those people to be undocumented, and we may audit all of your I-9s and prosecute you. So we've got the EEOC, we've got the Labor Department, we've got Social Security Administration in conflict with Homeland Security. In the meantime, we got, in this case, you have an employer who's trying to follow the law by completing an I-9. So why should he? Why shouldn't he just decide, I want all independent contractors. I don't have to comply with Obamacare, give them health insurance.
Yeah, that's a good question. Okay, Bob, have a question.
One quick question. How do you propose to block, I guess, the waiver that Congress or someone would be more likely to give to those people who cannot, because it says in here in item number two, including the criminal background check. We're running into this with the from Syria, the criminal background check.
I don't understand. What do you mean? Why do I propose to block the waiver? Why would you give anybody a waiver?
That's what I'm getting at.
Well, if they're a non-citizen, if they don't comply, they need to be put in jail or deported.
So who's responsible for obtaining this criminal background check? Because if you come from certain countries, you don't have the capability, period.
Oh, I agree with that. But to get a positive ID, they're going to have to first prove who they are, where they're from, with a passport or a birth certificate.
They can't do that.
You're going to absolutely know who they are. And then whatever you can do within those countries that have any records, you're going to try to verify their background. Are you going to have some bad guy slip through? Sure. I have hired several people who we thought had a great work clear and find out they've got a criminal record, and I'm using all of our American citizen systems. Okay? And so it's that some are going to slip through. But you got to require these, and anybody's not willing to comply, they need to go home or go to jail.
Yeah, I think you're on absolutely the correct track in requiring them. All I'm suggesting is that you're not going to get very many people from certain countries to ever meet that people.
Well, then they need to leave.
Okay.
They need to be gone.
Okay. Thank you.
All right.